Good morning, students. You were studying about the conventional source of energy. In that, you have studied about the fossil fuels and thermal power plant. Today, you are going to study about the hydroelectricity or hydropower plants and biomass, means biogas plant. You will study today. So, what is hydropower plant? Hydro name itself suggests that it is related to the water. Okay, so what happens in the hydropower plant? The plant is set up near the reservoir where the water is there. Okay, in the source of water nearby, what happened? They prepare a dam. A dam is prepared at because of the dam, what happens? It acts as a barrier, and because of that, the level of water increases near the dam. And the water increases, what happened? As you all know, that flowing water has kinetic energy. So when there is a barrier, when the dam is formed or when the dam is constructed, that time you can see the level of water rises. And when the level of water rises, the kinetic energy gets converted into potential energy because of the increasing in height. When the height is increasing, that time what happened? This water is carried through the pipelines at the bottom of the dam near the turbines. And because of this water, what happens? Because of the flowing of this water, because of this potential energy of the water, the turbine rotates. Okay, the water falls on the turbines, the turbine rotates, and when the turbine rotates, that time the electricity is generated. Okay, so this was the hydropower plant. Now we will study about the biomass. Okay, before going to biomass, I will tell the advantages of what are the advantages of hydropower plant. Yes, first of all, it is the renewable source of energy. Even though you are using the water continuously, the source can be refilled by the rain. When the rain will come, that time the water level will again increase. Okay, as it is a renewable source of energy, it is inexhaustible. Okay, it can be again replaced. Now we will go to the biomass. Biomass means what? Yes, it is the living matter or its residue that is called as biomass. And biomass, as you know, as it is biological factor, so it is what? It is not pollution causing. Okay, so it is how? It is a biodegradable and it is a renewable source of energy. As you know, in our nature there are plants, animals, so continuously what happens? There are biodegradable, there are always the sources. Okay, these are the sources through which we can get the biodegradable organic wastes. Okay, and this waste, using this waste, what we are going to do? We are going to produce the plant, biogas plant. Okay, and because of this, what things you can say? You can see that biomass is a renewable source of energy. Then what are the actually sources from where you will get this? New plant growth, then agricultural and forest residues. If you will see the remainings of agricultural and the remainings from the forest, all this can be collectively called as biomass. Then biodegradable organic effluents from industries. From industries also there are some wastes or some effluents that are biodegradable and also they are organic. So all these constituents you can use for the biogas plant. Now what is the biogas means actually? Biogas, it is a mixture of gases produced by anaerobic degradation. Okay, here anaerobic means what? Aerobic means with oxygen or with air, with presence of air. And anaerobic means what? Anaerobic means in absence of oxygen or air. Now here mixture of gases are produced, okay, through this degradation of such biomass. Okay, if you will degrade the biome, that it is in the absence of air or oxygen. Okay, that is called as anaerobic degradation. Now here and how it is in with the presence of water. Here water is also used, but here there is no oxygen or air. Now in this bioglass, what are the advantages of this biogas? as you know, it is the first advantage is it is a renewable source of energy. Second is it is very easily you can build it, even if some family has 3 or 4 head of cattle, so they can also easily prepare the biogas. And how it is, how much it can be prepared, the supply will be of biogas for 6 hours daily for cooking. This much gas can be produced by 3 to 4 heads of cattle. Okay, it is very easy to build, and as most important, it is a very clean fuel. It don't cause any pollution. Okay, then the spent slurry, and as it is a clean fuel means what? It will not leave any carbon, or it will not leave any ashes after burning. Okay, so the spent slurry, after this the spent slurry is rich in nitrogen and phosphorus, which can be a good manure also. This is also a very good benefit for this, that firewood is safe. Okay, for burning purpose, for cooking purpose, many peoples which are living in rural areas, they use firewoods, and that is also safe because of this biogas plant. And also the most important now condition, the most important thing we are seeing around us is the deforestation, that is also reduced. Now, what are the composition of the gases? This gas mainly contains methane, 75% methane and 25% carbon dioxide. Okay, so these are the main two constituents, and remaining you will find the traces of some gases, that is nitrogen and hydrogen. These are the traces of few gases which is found in this biogas plant. Now, there are two types of plant setup. It is fixed dome type, and second one is floating gas holder type setup is done. Okay, of this biogas plant. Now, in this, what is the working of the biogas plant? You can see the figure. In that, cattle dung and water are mixed in equal proportion in mixing tank to form slurry. This slurry is fed into the digester tank through the inlet tank. When the digester tank is filled about 2/3 of its capacity, the dome is left free for the collection of biogas. The slurry undergoes anaerobic fermentation, and biogas is produced after 50 to 60 days. As biogas is collected in the dome, it exerts pressure, due to which spent slurry goes to the overflow tank through outlet tank, and fresh slurry is flowed into the digester, and continuous supply of biogas is obtained. Spent slurry is used as manure. As I have told you, it acts as a good manure. So the remaining you can use as a manure. So this is the working of the biogas plant. Now, one more conventional source of energy is the wind energy. Now you know wind energy. Wind energy means now you can suddenly think about the windmills. Okay, because of the wind, the energy is produced. You all know about the windmill. When the wind comes, that time you can see the windmills, the blades of the windmills rotate, and it generates the electricity. Okay, that is the wind energy. So again, advantages of wind energy, as it is again renewable source of energy, wind will always come. Okay, so there is no any loss over there. It is very cheap source of energy. Okay, and there is no any pollution causing over there. It is renewable.